Weddings are a part of our everyday culture. In fact, 5 million people, or 2.5 million couples, get married in America each year. It's estimated that the wedding industry is a $60 billion a year industry. Some weddings are small and simple, while some couples spend upwards of $20,000 to $30,000 on big lavish weddings, and there are many that are in between. But no matter how much money was spent on the day, their wedding is something that they will adore and cherish for the rest of their lives. In my experience as a wedding videographer, I've had the privilege of attending several dozen weddings over the past few years, and I can tell you that no two weddings are the same. Every wedding is unique, and that's what keeps the business interesting to me. There are many details and much planning that goes into a typical American wedding. The bride has prepared as much as she could for the day, reading wedding books, magazine articles, and visiting countless websites. She's picked out the perfect dress. The reception hall, the wedding colors, the flowers, and even know what everyone will be having for dinner. What surprised me the most, however, was that once the wedding day arrives, the brides often admit they've never been to a wedding before. Even if they have been to a wedding, they are often unaware of the details that take place, such as how you stand with your dress for pictures, or how you cut the cake. So for those of you that might get married someday, you're in for a treat. This video will show you the culture that is weddings in America. The day begins with the bride getting ready. Sometimes the bride and the groom don't see each other until the wedding begins on the day of the wedding. Sometimes they see each other after they are dressed. Or they see each other for the very first time when the bride has walked down the aisle. Professional photos are usually taken before the ceremony. If the bride and groom have agreed to see each other before the ceremony, all pictures are taken. If not, then they take all the groomsmen and bridesmaid shots separately and take group shots after the wedding. After photos, guests arrive. Usually, guests are brought to their seats by an usher. Once everyone is seated, the procession begins. Traditionally, Canon in D is played. The ushers bring the bride and groom's grandparents to their seats. Then either the groom or an usher brings in either the groom's mother or both his mother and the bride's mother. Next, the bridal party enters. Sometimes the bridesmaids enter by themselves and meet up with the groomsmen near the altar, or they walk down the aisle together. They are then followed by the flower girl and ring bearer. The music changes to signify that the bride is about to enter. The audience stands. The bride is walked down the aisle by her father. At the end of the aisle, he gives his daughter away. Next, the ceremony takes place. Not all marriage ceremonies are religious, however, most follow the same format. The ceremony usually contains readings by friends or family, which can either be scriptures from the Bible or words of wisdom from an alternate source. The priest or presider will then give a sermon or tell a story about marriage to the couple. Sometimes there is a performance of music by a friend or family member. Eventually, it is time to state each other's vows and intentions. Sometimes the couples read the traditional vows.
Give myself to you.
As your husband.
As your husband.
I pledge my faithfulness to you.
I pledge my faithfulness to you.
Sometimes they make up their own.
Dear God, on this very special day, we humbly ask you to bless us in our journey together.
After the vows, they give each other rings, which are held onto by the best man until that point in the ceremony.
Jared, I give you this ring.
Jared, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And my faithfulness to you.
My faithfulness to you.
Once they have given the rings, they usually do either of two things. They light a unity candle, or they pour sand into a glass vase, a current popular trend. The couple usually ends the ceremony with a kiss. Fanfare plays, and the couple is introduced for the very first time as Mr. and Mrs.
Introduced for you for the very first time, Abby and Jeremy Johnson.
The couple usually have a receiving line where they meet with most everyone who attends the ceremony. After the receiving line finishes, the couple leaves the church with friends and family cheering them on. Rice was traditionally thrown at the couples, but it is most common now to blow bubbles. There are usually a couple of hours before the reception begins. Most couples take this time to go to a different location and take more photos with their wedding party. While waiting for the bride and groom to arrive, the reception hall will have a cocktail hour. This gives time for guests to arrive and mingle. Once the wedding party arrives, they are introduced to the Grand March. Often the couples will perform some kind of unique dance move to make their entrance memorable. From experience, the silliness or seriousness of the Grand March is a good indicator of how the rest of the evening will be. Guests can be served dinner in either two ways. Lower budget weddings generally have a buffet-style meal where people go and serve themselves. Higher budget weddings usually have several courses and are served at their tables. Once everyone has received their dinner, speeches and toasts are given. Most commonly, the maid of honor and the best man give speeches, followed by a thank you from the bride and groom. It is also becoming more common to hear toasts and stories from siblings and parents. Clinking silverware against glassware encourages the newlyweds to kiss. Some couples get really into it, while others specifically ask their guests not to do it, or offer an alternative activity. After the speeches, the couple usually cut the cake. Most couples are unaware of how to do this, so this is where the photographer's knowledge and expertise comes in handy. Usually the bride and groom cut the cake at the same time with the same knife, and then feed it to each other in a careful, loving way. The next part of the reception features the first dances. The bride and groom share their first dance together. Then, the bride dances with her father. Next, the groom dances with his mother. Sometimes, an anniversary dance follows in honor of the parents and grandparents. Then the real fun begins. The wedding party is invited to the dance floor. Some common party dances include the chicken dance, YMCA, and polkas. Most wedding receptions have a DJ playing music. However, there is still a demand for live music performance. At some point during the dances, the DJ usually announces that it's time for an activity.
We're going to do the garter toss and bouquet toss.
But there have been other activities as well, such as guessing which leg you're feeling blindfolded is your husband's. A dollar dance is typical as well, where people give the bride and groom money in order to dance with them. The bride tosses her bouquet over her shoulder to a group of unmarried women. The woman who catches it, superstition has it, will be the next to marry. The groom usually has to work to get the garter off the bride. He then tosses the garter to the single men at the reception. They usually aren't as eager to catch it as the single ladies. Eventually, the reception ends and everyone goes home. Each wedding is unique, but similar in many respects. Weddings have and will continue to be a very important part of our culture. I hope that this video has helped you get a better understanding of what takes place during a typical wedding day.
This magic moment, so different and